This is the SuperC tabletop CO₂ extractor.
I'm Chris with OCO Labs, and in this video we'll be going through the items which you should expect to find in the box when your system arrives, as well as how to assemble and begin production with your SuperC.
Should receive a user's manual, assembly instructions, and a sticker. We'll also provide you with a tank feed hose for connecting the CO₂ tank to your system. The collection vessel, vent valve, end cap, and chamber will also be included. For maintenance, we provide you with an O-ring pick to remove the O-rings from the cylinder, as well as an O-ring super kit.
As you work through the provided O-rings, it's important to make sure you keep spares on hand, so when you run low, please be sure to order replacements from our store.
Your system will also include the autopilot pressure regulator. It's comprised of these five parts, and I'll show you how to mount those next. To assemble your autopilot, you'll first need to mount the stepper motor to your vent valve. You need these two components, as well as the knob and drive belt. Tools you'll need are a 3/32 Allen key and a 1/4 inch wrench. First thing you'll need to do is to loosen the set screw on the knob that comes on your valve. Once that's loose enough, you'll be able to slide the knob off. Next, using the 1/4 inch wrench, we can remove the two mounting bolts. These are the mounting bolts we'll also use to mount the stepper motor. With the stepper motor and the valve oriented like this, you can take the bolts and replace them to capture the motor. At this point, we don't want to tighten the bolts too much, as we'll need the slack to tension the belt. With the mounting bolts most of the way snug and the plate pushed all the way forward, you can now mount the new knob and the drive belt. You want to be sure that this set screw lines up with the flat on the brass pin. Once they're aligned, you can tighten it, tension the belt, and secure the mounting bolts the rest of the way. And that is the assembled stepper motor and vent valve. With the stepper motor mounted, we can continue assembling our SuperC. The next step will be to connect our tank to our system using the tank feed hose. The tank feed hose will arrive with Teflon tape on the male end. There should always be about a turn and a half or 2 turns of Teflon tape on this fitting. If you remove the fitting or the tape is otherwise damaged, you should put about a turn and a half or 2 turns of fresh tape on. Mounting this fitting, you can start it by hand using a 9/16 wrench. We can finish snugging this fitting. As a general rule, snug is tight enough. If it's snug enough to seal, that's as tight as it should possibly need to be. The other end of the feed hose has a brass mount for the tank, and you should be certain to use tank spacer that comes with your hose. Like the male end of this feed hose, we can start this by hand, but make sure you use the appropriate size wrench to snug it down. One note about CO₂ tanks. Be sure to use a gas feed tank. There are two types of tanks, one which is called a dip tube or siphon tube tank, and the other which is a non-dip tube or non-siphon tube tank. You need to be using a non-siphon tube tank as it provides a gas feed. A liquid feed to the system can compromise the seals. Now that we've connected to the tank, we can mount our vent valve and chamber. The vent valve assembly with the stepper motor in place can be pushed through the gauge block like that. There is a pin and a hole which index to make sure that they're aligned correctly. The chamber is threaded on both ends identically, so it doesn't matter which end you put the end cap on. Sliding the chamber through the heating cradle, we can tighten it to the valve. We now connect our pressure sensor to this fitting, and this connection to our pressure sensor. The cable can then be connected to the control box, and the other cable connects the control box to the stepper motor. With the SuperC now assembled, our last step is to lubricate the system. Lubrication is an incredibly important part of SuperC ownership and maintenance, and will ensure that you get the longest life out of your seals possible. For lubrication, we recommend you use liquid at room temperature coconut oil. For ease of use, we recommend you keep an eyedropper bottle full of your coconut oil. It'll make it easier to apply the coconut oil directly to the felts in the system. Proper oiling means saturating the felts. If you've put enough oil onto your felts, you should be able to pinch them and see the oil pool up on the surface. You should repeat this at least every 3 hours of runtime. With your system fully assembled and lubricated, we can now pressurize. This is done by closing the valve on your system and opening the valve on your tank. When your tank is open, your gauge should jump up to 800 PSI. You should also hear your back check valve squeaking, which lets you know that they're sealing. At this point, we can kick the motor on and continue reaching up to our operating pressure.
If you'd like to learn more about our other products, be sure to watch our entire video series. If you have questions, you can reach us at info@ocolabs.com. I'm Chris with OCO Labs. Thanks for watching.